hard and be kind.
And play hard.
We love you. Work hard and be kind and play hard. So that we can be proud of you as well. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating the class of 2017.
Taking a video. We're gonna graduate. Vanessa went to high school. I love it.
Well, I've been called our group the Dweebs.
You guys, the Dweebs.
The Dweebs.
Dweebs. The Dweebs, coined by Vanessa.
I think I came up with that name too. I called you guys the Dweebs.
That's because we were all in comic book club when we were in high school.
A lot of you guys, when you guys were into like comics and stuff like that.
You get a group that I didn't think I'd be this close with, but over time as we progress, it's like, why would we not be close if we hang out all the time? We talk about nerdy things, we talk about life.
I really feel like everybody has a different little personality and they kind of brings into the group.
We come from different cultures and backgrounds, but we all like similar things.
There's definitely some nerdy, but still some crazy, some introverted, but you know, overall like a family vibe.
Passionate. Creative, like loving, caring, and that's what I think of the group.
And you guys are all interesting characters. You know, Josh is his own guy, DJ, you know, Vanessa, like they're all their own people, you know, RC, and we just like all vibe on a level where it's like we don't need to talk about things that are like, we don't need to like all the same things. I know damn well Vanessa doesn't like Marvel and DC like that, but we still all vibe, right?
After we graduated, we kept the group solid, that little inner circle, we kept it going, and just that name stuck.
My name is Vanessa Alcantar.
My name is Kevin Prasad.
My name is Arsalan.
My name is Joshua Montes.
My name is Noah Abel, and I am 22 years old.
22.
I'm 22 years old.
And I'm 21 years old.
I am a nursing major.
At first it was journalism, and then I started doing acting and film.
A business administration major.
I was a history major.
I'm a film major.
I've attended two different schools. One is a university, and that is the San Francisco State University. And the one that I go to now that I transfer to, a community college, and that is Chabot.
I go to Chabot College, it's a community college.
I went to Sonoma State University. I just graduated class of 2021.
Currently go to UC Riverside, and by the time this comes out, hopefully I'm already graduated. Or I have graduated.
We had a lot of classes in common, and the fact that we also were very involved with school activities and the club, that really brought us together after school, on the weekends, and during a lot of like extracurriculars.
Every single person that was there, you know, in our little group, we ended up connecting and bonding just by our conversations and the way that we got along with each other. I think especially me and you, Noah, we shared like pretty like deep moments and stuff like that when we spoke to each other. So I just feel like that happened in between everybody.
It was proximity, right? So like being close to you guys, having people there that are supporting, you know, it's like a support system, right?
It was the uniqueness of everybody that drew everyone like closer.
It's when you have people that are there for you, that are close to you, and you know that if you're down and out, you can go to them for answers and, you know, advice.
High school, you know, you go through a lot of crap. You go through breakups, you know, you go through family problems and troubles. And I was really excited to go to class every day because when I was with that group, it took my mind off all my problems. So we definitely were all there for each other when we needed to be, because I could recall stories of, you know, Vanessa calling me crying about something and me like going there and picking her up and you know, being there for Kevin, being there for Josh. Josh always called me up as well whenever, you know, going through problems, and, you know, just became closer because of that.
I did.
I was iffy about that.
I wasn't so sure about that.
It was all up in the air, because I definitely wished and hoped that we would all stay together, but it was hard because we had people in our group going to a different state for college, going to a different country, going to different cities. So that's definitely hard for being young, trying to keep everybody together.
I thought that a lot of us were going to move away. I mean, I certainly was almost 2 hours away, living on campus, so I was only able to come down for maybe once a month, maybe less than that.
I went to high school in India, and when I completed my high school, it's only up till 10th grade, I lost a lot of friends. A lot of friends just, they seemed to be friends then, but not really. Like I've told people before this, it's time that tells who your real friends are, and I kind of did expect that a little, but I was wrong, I guess.
I thought we would drift off eventually, but it's crazy how we have had our moments where we drift off, but we always seem to come back.
I had a feeling that like we would just either be the same as we were in high school, or we would grow a little closer. I didn't think we would drift apart. I don't think, you know, like that's sort of maybe a stigma that people have. It's like, oh, we're going to drift apart, and it happens, you know. We're going to just part because we're going to not be close to each other, whatever. But I think that distance, in a sense, helped us. Because whenever we were distant, we came back. We had all these stories to tell, all these things to, you know, come at each other with and help each other with. So,
what are some of your goals in 2017 going into your first year of college?
I think some goals that I have for myself were definitely to keep pursuing it and always pursue it regardless of what happened. So keep my mind set on nursing, like have that in mind. Also, I wanted to keep that drive throughout all those years, because I know people really tend to lag and they tend to lose that motivation. So I really had that in mind for me. And just to overall be proud of my work at the end of it and, you know, just complete it, I think.
The goal was just to, it was following a gap year, so my goal was just kind of get off my ass and do something, you know, excuse my language, but like it was just, I had this idea that I can do one thing and one thing well throughout high school, and it was writing. And my goal was to like harness something, you know, do something with your life that, you know, you feel passionate about. One of those things is writing. And of course I realized that journalism was not going to do that over time, but that was just my goal, was just master something, get something done.
Yeah, so when I first started college, I didn't know what I wanted to do. So I looked at like my hobbies and like passions, and I thought, oh, maybe I could try this, I could try that. But then I really thought about it, is like the way I look at it is like, I, as long as I have a financially stable job, then I can focus on, you know, doing my hobbies and passions, you know. And at first I was like, oh, maybe videography or like cinematography, but it was only like a certificate course at Chabot, and I was like, I was more looking for a bachelor's. And then my dad was into business administration. I think that that's what kind of drew me to business admins, because it's an essential job.
I was very excited to start fresh. I wanted to kind of, you know, reinvent myself. I feel like in high school is a lot of the same people that you grew up with in elementary school and beyond. So, you know, going to college in a different town far away from everyone you know really is good or bad depending on your perspective. And I was jumping in with like both feet, you know, trying to just, I don't know, see what kind of new adventures I could get into. I was super excited to get involved with campus.
I first got accepted, and my first year of college, I went to the University of Oregon. My major was, back then, journalism. So my goals into going to University of Oregon I had a different mindset as I did now, of course, being 4 years ago, but I was kind of sick of being at home, being in the Bay Area, being in the East Bay, and just doing the same thing every day, seeing the same people every day. You know, I love my friends and family to death, but I wanted to go out there and explore the world and see how it was. That's why I was, when I was graduating and looking forward to Oregon, I was kind of in the mentality of no looking back. Like, this is it, and I'm going to have a new life, and going to have the most fun. So my goal was to have the most fun in Oregon, but that didn't really work out.
It's very common that people do take gap years after high school. What was the reason you took a gap year?
I think it was just me being tired of being in an educational system that doesn't provide for me. You know, it was just this whole thing about, oh, you have to do school, you have to do these things. It's like, I'm doing these things, but I'm barely scraping by. People aren't stopping to help me. You know, the only reason I passed high school is because my algebra two teacher was like, he didn't even mind me not finishing the test. He just passed me because he knew that if I took that test, I would have failed. And it's this whole system that like is geared towards the people that are successful. They're gonna stay successful. The people that are under, you know, pressure and are not doing well, it's almost like we're just going to leave you behind. You just have to find yourself. And, you know, it just didn't provide for me. So I had to take a year off, just relax.
Going to SF was super different than high school, I feel like. It just felt like literally a bigger high school, but everybody minded to themselves. High school was a lot like everybody knew each other when you would come, and now this is a whole new playing field. It was, you know, tons of different personalities, a lot of different people. You felt like very small.
So when I first went to college, it was totally different than high school. You know, high school, we got same periods every single day, 5 days in a row. College was nice and fun because you had two classes probably. Most classes were two classes in a week, and that was like an hour to an hour and a half. And you had a lot of free time to do other things. So I really like appreciated that about college. The thing I was scared of was if I'm doing the right thing that I like. But it's like you gotta try it to see if you like it or not.
Me and all of my roommates, we all lived on campus. So when we moved into the dorms, there was a lot of excitement. That was like, it feels almost like it was a vacation in some ways, because you're in a big old dorm with a bunch of people your age, and everybody's excited, everyone's happy to meet each other, and it was honestly like just so much positivity. So that was like the initial vibe going in and starting the school semester. So I just remember like it was lots of good memories and lots of like everyone is very enthusiastic.
What I was most excited about was sort of just trying to find something for myself, maybe finding a passion that I could stick with. But it doesn't work like that, you know. We try to think like, okay, I'm just gonna experiment, but we don't have that much time to experiment. We have to take specific classes, pay for these classes, right? But I was also excited to meet new people, so that was the caveat there. That was like the, you know, double edge. It's like I might not have found what I wanted to do, but I found people that were good for me. And what I was afraid of was exactly sort of what happened, was sort of just being there just to be there.
When I the night before I moved to Oregon, I came to the realization that like, I don't know, I won't see the dweebs that much anymore, as much as I did back in high school, because we saw each other every day. But also my family, I was so scared being far away from them, because, you know, I was kind of babied as a kid and sometimes now by my family, and they really like, you know, babied me. So going into a place where, you know, Oregon is crazy because Eugene, Oregon is kind of unreachable. Like, you have to take like two planes and a bus to get there. It's like 8 hours away and you have to go through a trek to get there. So it looked like a dome with all the trees. So it seemed very isolated. And, you know, I was just scared of being alone.
Show. Hey, where are we going?
Tracktown Pizza!
Why?
Because we're getting some motherfucking free pizza.
Yeah, you'll all do it. And it works!
No, how was your day?
It was good. Stop, I look really ugly right now, Noah. It was good. I had to run a lot.
How many classes did you have today?
Two discussion classes.
So they're
that were 50 minutes long.
That's not that bad. I had 4 classes.
Oh, no way. That's a little rough. But, yeah. But other than that, it was pretty good. I got to see my friend Noah.
Who's that? He sounds...
He's dope. And I can't go out tonight.
Huh?
Oh my god. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Yeah, but I'm going out now. My friends convinced me.
Gotta memorize about...
Room service.
Is he still sick?
I think so.
I fucking hitched a ride.
What's up, pussy? How you doing?
Good,
smells like pizza. You look hella different, bro. Did you lose weight?
Yeah, I actually did. I was really sick this last week. I lost like 8 pounds.
How you feeling?
A lot better.
You kind of look like you've been doing math. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Come on, come here. Give it to me. Give it to me.
I don't have anything cool to do right now.
What did we do? It shows me, right?
Yes.
Okay.
How was your first year of college? What did you enjoy and what didn't you enjoy?
So my first year of college was fun because my first day I made friends with my most best closest friend ever, Amir, as you guys know. The best part was I was into a program called First Year Experience, where a lot of people that were first time in college with the same major, so we all were put into the same class, we had the same schedule, because with the same people it would be more comfortable. So I really liked that about college. College went really good for me. I was, my grades were good. Everything was going well.
I really liked the fact that I felt a little bit in solitude because it actually helped me focus a lot more when it came to my studies. So because of that, I isolated myself a lot in libraries, you know, eating, you know, the cafeteria, wherever it was. It helped me study a lot better, helped me focus.
I enjoyed finding new people, meeting new people, having some teachers that could maybe give me some advice on the side.
Well, there were a lot of clubs. I got involved with a lot of like martial arts clubs. There was a jiu-jitsu club that was like a huge family. And I did martial arts back in high school, so carrying that over was really nice because it was like an instant connection with all these new people.
The film program there and the people that were associated with the film program, I met a lot of friends that I still talk to this day that I connect with because we all have the same interest of making movies. But unfortunately, I kind of found them a little too late in my University of Oregon life.
Some of the things that I didn't like about it was that it was kind of hard for me to make friends because I didn't dorm there. So I didn't really necessarily have a clique or a group. I had that friend or two in that one or other class, you know.
The offside was, you know, just sort of not enjoying my time overall because I wasn't learning much. And I realized that how am I going to do journalism is not, you know, a very lucrative job. So it's like, why would I do that? I'm not even that interested in it. So, you know, it was a up and down.
You got to adjust to, you're no longer with your family. You're living with a bunch of other boys your age. So, you know, all of the habits and the things you were used to back home doesn't necessarily apply anymore. So, you know, a lot of things I didn't like was like my roommates were not very cleanliness. There was a lot of just nasty laundry and garbage lying around, and no one was cleaning. So in some aspects, I felt like I was the parent, kind of checking up on everyone, saying, hey, can we clean up? Can we take out the trash? Can we do the dishes? Like, there's stuff literally rotting in the fridge. And, you know, you bring over a friend, and the whole house smells bad. So there are some things like that that you don't expect, but you got to deal with it and get serious.
It was my fault. I should have done more research about, you know, how it was. I don't know. It's just, I found out that it wasn't for me. And there's a lot of reasons why it wasn't for me. I can't just give one. It's not solely because I didn't like it. Meeting those film people, and I obviously had a love for film back in high school, but I realized that I wanted to do that as a living and as a career. And being in journalism classes it just wasn't for me. It's a sports school, party school, and big on football. And I thought that it was all really cool, but like, I'm not that into football. I'm not that into sports besides basketball. So like, it just wasn't for me. College is filled with, to be completely honest, college is filled with a lot of drinking, a lot of drugs, a lot of dumb decisions, stupid kids. The adult part of that is trying to find your way through and surviving through all of those weird adventures, going out with your friends and trying to find your way home and stuff. It definitely depends on the social life depends on where you go to, because obviously if you go to like a D1 school or a state college party school, then you're obviously going to be more inclined to get into the party scene more. But then again, you know, partying is fun, and I've done my fair share of it, I guess, but there are specific schools, maybe like University of Oregon, where it's big on that, and frat life there was huge. And if you weren't really part of a frat or an organization like that, that encouraged, you know, partying and all of that, you're kind of left out a lot. So that's where I kind of found myself. Like, I didn't want to be part of a frat, so I found most nights were my roommates and friends that were out late at night, and I was just by myself making movies and films and editing videos. And, you know, it didn't really feel that great.
Because San Francisco State was so big, finding like a clique or like a friend group to hang out with was pretty hard for me. I think because you had so many different classes and everybody had the same goal, was to kind of just focus on themselves and focus on their career. It was hard to find other people that wanted to focus with you, if that made sense. Versus Chabot, everybody has the same goal. Everybody wants to transfer to a four-year university, and because of that, people are more willing to help each other and more willing to become friends and socialize in that sense.
The biggest like misconception is like, oh, you go to college, it's all like parties everywhere, this, that, and that's complete. No, it's all very subjective on the college you go to, like, especially like community colleges. It's hard to find those like house parties, and my social life in college wasn't party. It was having just good times with the friends that I had. You know, we coming back to my previous answer, we had a lot of free time. So after classes, we would go to the gym together. Me and my friends go grab a post workout meal, and then have a nice chat, and then get home, and then rinse, repeat.
Well, Sonoma State is not a very big university. It's not known as like a big party school. You know, it's kind of a small college town, but it is also pretty tight-knit depending on what circles you are in. You know, there's a lot of Greek life. I personally was not really involved with Greek life, but, you know, it's a small enough campus that eventually you get to know everybody. So, you know, there's a lot of functions. There's a lot of like out of campus activities going on. There's parties. It's a good time. I really enjoyed it.
Is it true that the college education system is unfair? If so, what did you do to help yourself out financially?
Oh yeah, I definitely think it's way too expensive when it came to San Francisco State. I got a scholarship, thank God that I did, because if not, my family would have been indebted, I think, $15,000 to $17,000 for just my first year. And later finding out that all of those were just, you know, general ed classes, and for them to just be like that, that's not even my major classes, it made me pretty upset finding that out later. It did. I think it was very hard, especially in San Francisco State, to even get classes, because everybody else that was I think like juniors and seniors got priority. They always did. So us freshmen were stuck with, you know, shitty classes and stuff like that. So, and counseling was very hard to get because there was thousands of students, thousands of freshmen. So I would have to wait like a week or two to get an appointment. And then, but you know, my due date for my classes was within the next few days. So I didn't really get help like that. So I wish that I did.
I financially wasn't, you know, stable. Like, even my family wasn't, so but financial aid was really like a good help. You know, they waive your fee away, and then they still give you money for your expenses in college and stuff. But the other side of it was, if you wanted to get more money, you had to go and work, and if your income was going up, then your federal aid would come down. So it was kind of unfair on that part, because yeah, I wanted to go to school, get the full experience of college, but at the same time I wanted to financially help my family, and that wasn't really allowed, I guess.
College education system, I would say it's a little unfair, because personally, as a film major, I didn't really enjoy having, I mean, the class itself was fun, but knowing that I had to pay and write essays towards classes like psychology or Spanish or English, well, maybe English helps because it helps me write films, but like psychology and Spanish class and some of the extracurricular courses, like I took some sciences too, classes like that, even though the professors were awesome and the classes were nice, they didn't really cater toward my future, and I still had to pay for it and dedicate time for that. So I was really frustrated when I wanted to go make a movie, make a film, and get experience on the field, but I had to do a paper about biology. It didn't make any sense to me, and it still doesn't. So I feel like the general education, the GE part of college, is a little bit unnecessary. It's just way too expensive. Like, it's way too expensive when you have colleges in Europe and other parts of the in other countries that are free, and us having to pay for all of that, and like having to pay for that for years on after we graduate. It's not really something you want to look forward to after graduating, having to pay your bills.
It is somewhat unfair to people that, you know, aren't going for something that's lucrative, right? Or like aren't going for something that's like, it all comes down to money. And you know, for me, it's like, it's not that it was a money thing, because you know, it was about 500 to 1,000 just to get for a semester or two, right? But still, it's like,
is this an earthquake?
Yeah.
You want to go under the door here right quick? Kevin, come on, what are you doing?
Because I'm scared.
Don't be scared.
Also.
What the heck?
That was an earthquake.
Going back to the dweebs, what was better about all being together and hanging out now that you were all in college? Did you notice the social aspect between you all changed from high school?
Yeah, I definitely think so. I feel like everybody opened up a lot more. Everybody grew into their character. And I think that's what like adulthood, college, and all of that does to you, is like you start to realize yourself and who you are. And because of that reason, you know, everybody started to develop themselves and their characteristics a lot more.
We're just all mature, and I feel like it's better now because we have our high school, or maybe like 2 or 3 years of all being close in high school, and we added on to now the 4 years of college experience, and we're all... We all went through that together, so that's 7 years of having our own problems and going to each other to solve them. So it's more of like, after all of these years, we all understand each other more, And I feel like that's why we're closer.
Going back to when I said, like, distance helps, in a sense, right? Well, like, while we were in high school, sure, we hung out a little bit more, but it was, like, more just, like, we're just hanging out because we needed each other, because we had each other at the time, right? And it didn't feel as, like, every moment was great with you guys, right? But it wasn't, like, oh, it's a grand reunion every time. But now that, like, we went our separate ways, we come back, it's, like, this brand new feeling with you guys. It's, like, we're experiencing life together all while being separate. I got all the time in the world. Don't you want some of that? I got all the time in the world. Don't you want some of that? Don't you want some of that?
You had to come to terms with now after experiencing your first year of college?
The difficulties was, it's just realizing that life is not stopping for you, you know, and it kind of sucks. It's like, oh, but I, like, people always tell me, it's like, you gotta be in college, you gotta make something out of yourself, right? You can't take this route or this route or this route. It's like, oh, you have to do this. And it's like, I have so much pressure. My parents always ask me, when are you going back to school? When are you going to go to college again? It's like, whatever. And it's like, I don't feel the need to, you know. But then it's all this outside pressure. Like, okay, how am I going to provide for myself when I'm older? So, you know, that's the scary part. That's, you know, that's the hard part right there.
I definitely had the realization that you really have to go out and seek for help. You definitely really do. And I felt like it was going to be a little bit of hand-holding, at least, you know, how we did have in high school. You know, those counselors kept checking up on us, you know, we had a lot of support. And, you know, they always said, you know, you have to grow up at some point and they're not going to help you. And the hard reality was they were not going to help us. And I had to look for everything myself. I had to look for all these resources, all these clubs, and nothing was really given to you. And the amount of success, too, like, it really accounted to how much help you wanted to get as well. So it was definitely like a, like, go get it or get lost.
Second year of college different from the first?
Definitely after the first year I wasn't working, and I think the second year it kind of hit us a bit hard, because the person that was with my sister, who's working in our family, she wanted to resume her education, and that's when I had to step in and pitch in for the family while I give her a chance, because she gave me a chance. So I had to add a part-time job, and that's when I noticed that full-time school, part-time job is a bit of sacrifice. Financial aid kind of drops a little. At the same time, my grades dropped.
I had a completely different village that I was living in. So there's different areas for upperclassmen and lowerclassmen, and I was paired up with random roommates. So, you know, it's kind of like you just roll the dice and see what you get. My roommates for second year were, like, very quiet. They, you know, they didn't want to, they weren't very social. And, you know, that's okay. Everyone has different things that they're interested in. So a couple times we would, like, get together and do, like Dungeons and Dragons or movie night, or, like, play video games and stuff, just to kind of, like, build a little bit of a relationship. But most of the time, it was like we were strangers, just sharing the same space. So you kind of like learn to just live on your own. You don't need roommates, and they don't have to be your best friends. It's nice if they are, but you know, a lot of times you end up just saying hi and bye, and you do your own thing.
Second year was me realizing I joined an acting class, right? And I was like, holy shit, I'm good at this. Not only am I good at this, it's something that I enjoy. I'm passionate about it. The craft was very similar to rap, you know, where it's like, oh, you have to switch this piece out here. And thank God I had a great teacher, right? A great professor, former actor. And like, I was learning from one of the best. So it's like the first year was just this whole lot of nothing. Me just doing it just to do it. The second year was like, oh, I'm going to switch to film. I'm going to do acting in film. It's something that I enjoy.
For my second year of college, I went back home and went to community college for a year. And there was a big difference because University of Oregon, everybody wants to party. But in the community college I went to, American River College, everybody had the mentality of get in, get out. I didn't make any, I don't have any friends from American River College that I still talk to this day because they all went separate ways. And I spent a lot of my second year of college working and making money at my part-time job, and I actually found friends that I still talk to at the job I worked at. Yeah, community college was working a lot about myself and the decisions I made. Well, the first year was, I don't know, not understanding what was going on.
Now, having experienced 2 years of college back in 18, 19, what are some problems about college that you feel doesn't get talked about enough?
It doesn't get talked about enough. I think definitely one of them is a lot more mental health support. I think because in San Francisco State, there wasn't a lot of coverage about that stuff. It was more like, okay, you can join this sorority, you can go to this whatever club, there's, you know, Spanish club, whatever it was. And there was not a lot of mental health like coverage on that stuff. And then versus Chabot, they covered that a lot. They promoted that a lot. So there was, we even had like a health center that you can get your own, you know, mental health counselor, and it was free, you know. And the fact that that's such an important topic, I feel like, to cover, because we college students go through a lot, physically, financially, spiritually, emotionally, we go through a lot. And I felt like that was such a great topic that Chabot covered that I wish bigger universities would bring more attention to.
The need of unnecessary education, that the price of education, you know, I come from a third world country. People fly out there. For example, Momin, he went to Pakistan to get his, you know, medical degree. He's paying way less money there than here and spending way less like time over there than here he would. Student loan debt, you know, I have a family member that's going through that too. Have coworkers and friends that go through that too, you know.
There's more enthusiasm about like party culture than there is like the actual academics. I was very disappointed in multiple times that the academics was very, I don't know how to explain, that as a higher institution, it was supposed to be, we were all led to believe that this was a higher institution of learning. And a lot of times things felt very juvenile. I felt like we were not even in high school. I felt like we were in like elementary school in some situations. Like things were so babied down and like dumbed down. And I was thinking, you know, we're all adults here, so we can handle difficult topics. But I think it really depends on what class you're in, whether or not you're taking an elective or if it's part of your major, you know, what your major is. So I'm sure it differs from scenario to scenario. But I would have liked to see like more challenging topics in classes. You don't get that until you're at your final year in upper division.
There's a lot of people I know who want to dream big and want to travel to different colleges and different universities and want to thrive, but they can't because it's too expensive. And that's very unfair because, you know, why do we have to pay to learn? You know, it's really stupid.
Which one?
The red. It's a red button.
Red button?
Yeah, I take a state test.
Yeah, you told me.
But then What the heck?
And then after that, I can work on a BLS today.
It's a video, sorry.
Noah looks like such a nerd.
Welcome to Union City.
That's a bit, man.
What are some takeaways you have about the dweebs that you appreciate now that you didn't before?
Time. I think in high school you feel like time is just sitting there. It's always there. You're there every day. And I think now that we're in college and we're adults, we have jobs, we have lives, and you know, just hanging out with those original people that you were with, that time is very limited now. And I feel like as I've gotten older and kind of went through all these struggles, I started to realize that time is of the essence and you're not going to get it back. So I think I just appreciate time.
I think going back to high school, it was like I sort of didn't realize how meaningful it was to have people that are inviting you out, whatever, like do these things with you. And it felt good to have friends, right? Like in high school, you don't want to be the outside kid with no support group, right? It hurts. I've been in that position. But then like moving forward, it's like now that I realize that you guys are still here, that's what helps the most. You know, it's because, you know, a lot of times in high school or after high school, it's like they're hanging out with you there, but they weren't there for you all the way through. You know, they went their own way and they forgot about you. They didn't want to make plans, right? You know, that's the difference. It's like now I realize you guys are real. You know, you guys are real, really there for me, real ones, and really care. And so that's what matters.
Well, yeah, I mean, having a group of friends to come back to, you know, that is, it's really priceless, because once you're up at college and you live there, you know, you kind of begin to forget about your life back home. You kind of are like in a bubble, right? But then when school's over and everyone goes back home, people live in San Diego, people live in Los Angeles, people live out of state, you know, so then everyone's back to where they started before college, right? And having a solid group to go back to is really nice, because, you know, you think you're friends with a lot of people, but then that distance hits you immediately during summer break or when you graduate. And then you realize, wait a second, like this little family that I had in college, like it only exists in college. And a lot of the time it's just going to fizzle out unless you like make the effort to like drive down to San Diego, you know, but that's on a very rare thing.
Definitely the meetups that we do plan, which aren't, of course, as often, they're just way more special. And it's more of just taking consideration of the people, my friends as individuals and us as a group, you know, how special they are, how unique and how caring they are, caring about me and all of that, like them being there after what I've been through in Oregon. So it's just, I appreciate them more.
It's a video. What's up, guys? Hey, this is a video. Welcome to Noah's birthday.
Get in here, guys. Get in.
There's my Abe. There's Kevin. There's Josh. Noah.
My name is Kevin. Can I release my mixtape?
Alright. Ready?
Yeah.
Alright. Hey.
I look sweaty.
But everyone looks. Happy birthday, Noah!
Spider-Man fan, say a phrase from Spider-Man 1, Tobey Maguire.
Telly ho.
You know what I noticed? In every single one of your videos, my hair is never done. Like, something is always wrong with my hair.
Please do. Are you, is it recording?
I'm never
behind the camera?
No, I mean in front of the camera. I've never.
Dude, this is really sick. Like, actually, like, it looks really good. Is there a filter on this?
Nope. Wow. Wait, what's wrong with my pants?
Hopes or expectations do you guys have for this summer?
Sure. I want to go to Galaxy's Edge, but one, every time I get money, something happens, and I have to give it away.
Oh, yeah, that sucks.
Yeah, so.
We heard about your little mishap.
You don't want to talk to me. Please don't talk.
Oh, my God, look at Kevin. That was candid. He wasn't even doing that for the vlog.
Dude, wait, you remember the fucking, the us?
No, I didn't watch that movie.
God damn it, Vicky.
This is Vanessa. I don't know why I'm introducing everybody. If you've watched my videos before, you know who everybody is.
Yeah.
Oh my God. You don't need to. It's not important.
I should know.
Who's your favorite, what's your favorite song from Wu-Tang?
Probably.
Oh shit, fake fan. Fake fan alert.
The mystery of chess boxing.
What the fuck shit, was dude. That? You're in my fucking way, man.
What goes this way?
Are we recording?
Yeah, we're recording. Vicky's visiting from San Diego, and she used to live with us, and she's, yeah, she's visiting.
You sound hella jumbled.
I'm jumbled. Vicky, what's one thing you love about San Diego?
I just like the vibes, the environment. I'm just looking at myself, not even the camera. I like the proximity to the beach, the weather.
Will be a screenshot.
Yeah,
we'll fix everything. It's definitely tough, though. It's falling off. Going into your third year of college, how would you describe the relationship life in college, and how was your relationships like in college?
Well, that's funny you say romantic. I feel like, I don't want to sound too cynical, but I feel like in college, romance is dead. I feel like there's more of, I feel like there's a lot of sex culture. It's not so much like people are looking to be dating. You know, I dated a couple girls. I had a few relationships. But overall, I feel like college is a very chaotic environment. And it's easy to get, you know, swooped up into like a lot of destructive habits. And there's a lot of like drinking and sleeping around happening. And it's hard to maintain like a genuine connection because you have a lot of bad role models, and there's not that many good examples of people who are in relationships. There's a lot of people who are cheating, and there's just a lot of like bad situations going on. So, you know, if you're looking for a romantic connection, you have to really look for the right person.
I think definitely, you know, going through relationships through high school was very different than it was with college, because in high school you were cuddly and you saw each other all the time and it was such a giggly high school thing. And versus college, it's like, okay, now we're adults and we have to really make time to focus on ourselves and trying to find the balance between relationships and school and work and your personal life. It's really, really hard, and I think it takes a toll on a lot of relationships. It's really difficult because you have to learn to prioritize yourself when you need to learn to also prioritize somebody else. So it was a really hard balance, I think, to manage both. And it did have a strain sometimes because, you know, you can't have time for this person. You can't really express, you know, certain things to this person. You know, mentally you're going through a lot. So, you know, it's really difficult, but, you know, at the end of the day, you can make it work.
Again, University of Oregon, I found that there are a lot of, I don't know, girls who, you know, it's just what it depends on what people want. You know, me personally, I, you know, moving away to a big school, 8 hours away, I was looking for a, you know, companionship for someone you know, very intimate and special just to talk to someone and, like, you know, be there. And I didn't really find it because the girls I did meet there were more of like the party type and like more of just like the fling. I don't know. There's just some people there that, you know, didn't look for an Asian dude who is artsy and loved film and rather looking for, you know, more athletic types. So, yeah, college is a lot of meaningless, you know, get-togethers, and that could be fun for some people, but not really what I was looking for. I was really depressed in Oregon for being alone, and the beginning of my community college life there, I was still depressed and alone. But you know, I luckily found someone, and I did not meet her in my college, but you know, it's good.
Okay. Like it sometimes it's just not the right place. You know, I think a lot of times people kind of force it, or people it's like okay, we're here together, we might as well do it. Might as well just be in a relationship. You know, there are people that are like, you know, it's kind of there's the other end of the spectrum where it's like, forget a relationship. There's all these girls or all these guys. Like, why would I choose one person? Whatever. And then there's that end where it's like, we're here, we might as well just start here. And, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I think it's just, you just need two people on the same page. That's it. And it's kind of hard to do that in college, I would say.
Tell me one crazy story, incident you've experienced or have heard in college.
Can we come back to that one? Let me think.
It was with my friends. It was me and Amir. We were going to go out and eat. So since we're all Muslim, right? So Arabic music, we like to listen to it a little bit. We're at a stop sign and people were just staring into the car because we're like singing, just being out loud and notorious. And then the light turns green, and then I expected, oh, the cars are gonna move, and I see the car in front of me move a little, so I was a little heavy footed on the gas, and then he stopped because there was traffic, and then by the time I slammed on the brake, I hit his back bumper, and yeah, no more Nancy in the car.
I was with somebody. It was about 1 a.m. 1:30, and in the Cyril's parking lot, it's a parking lot, me and this person, shots ring off, and it was one car here, killed him, ran around, and I was in this situation where I was in, you know, it was under pressure, but I'm, you know, completely was calm in that moment. I realized what had happened, assessed it, and got this person to stay down. Made sure that car got around and waited till police came. So it was just a crazy story where it's like, and I handled it well, and now it's not really a traumatic thing for me. It's just sort of like that actually happened.
Yeah, well, I mean, in high school, obviously in high school, everybody's a minor, and like the only parties are going on is like with like maybe football or basketball circles. But in college, it's like, every opportunity people get, it doesn't matter. It could be during the weekday. It could be any day. You know, it could be Wednesday. People figure out a reason to start having a function. They say Wine Wednesday. Just because Wednesday, we're going to have wine. And everyone comes over and we all drink. Or, you know, Cesar Chavez Day, we get the day off. So everyone's going to have like a day party, day drinking. And like, it's just goofy. Like, everyone is just looking for an excuse to... Because we all live on campus, so there's like no parents, there's no supervision, so every day is an opportunity.
Let me think. We'll come back to it.
Well, I mean, there's so many. Honestly, I've talked with a lot of friends, and I feel like I could write a book just about every page is just a different silly college situation that you would never be in otherwise. It's only in college. Like, I mean, people showing up, like, I knew a guy who showed up to class. We had a 3.5 hour class once a week, and nobody wanted to be there because it was so long, people would fall asleep. So I knew a guy who brought a hydro flask full of vodka, like mixed drinks or beer, and he would just be drinking in the back of class. Or, you know, people would be like vaping in class when the teacher's not looking. Or, you know, we had a wildfire one of the years, and the whole school had to evacuate. And I remember my roommate woke up at like 3 a.m. because of the emergency siren, and he says, "Oh, we're evacuating. You know what that means?" And he pulled out a bottle of Jack Daniels, and he was like, "It's time to take shots." And I looked at him and I was like, "Dude, you're crazy. We need to get out of here. We need to get in the car and figure out what we're doing, because there's fire and ashes flying everywhere. Like, now's not the time to be partying." And he's like, "Let's take shots. Who cares? Like, the world is ending." And I'm just like, you know, what is happening, you know? I mean, there's so many. It's hard to nail it down to one. But probably the big group outings, or like the club events that we go into San Francisco, or we go to Lake Tahoe, and the whole group rents out a hotel. I've been to one outing where there's about 80 of us, maybe close to 100 of us, and we rent out like an entire block of this like cul-de-sac, and the entire street is just filled with college kids partying and dancing, and music is just blasting down the street. And I just remember one moment, I walk in one of the hotel rooms, and there are like these girls dressed as like Playboy bunnies, and they're dancing on the bed. And there's like vodka bottles in people's hands, and music's playing. And then that's the moment when I just realized to myself, I was like, damn, like this is probably like the college experience, if you want to call it, you know.
When did I give that to you?
Comic-Con. I was like, today's the perfect day to wear it. Yeah.
Well, at least on the bright side.
This and our El Ponche. I made it El Ponche, that makes that drink good.
You were picking too hard. And, yeah. Let me get a close up.
No.
Let me get a close up.
I just started to have a nosebleed. Yeah, I'm all right.
Just have to cool down.
I gotta wash my hands.
You guys get a good shot play. I'll show you again. It's next semester for sure. I should be one more free.
Huh?
Yeah.
No, I'm down.
You gotta let it sit.
Yeah, my hair. Ah! So you just stole a cat.
Well, they're like on the street. So.
Instead of
it was
free.
It was first come first serve. Huh?
Yeah. First come first serve. 1, 2, 3.
All right, there's a couple.
Thank you.
Oh. Am I taking a picture?
Sure.
Just...
sure.
During COVID, what things did you miss the most about college, and what did you miss most about the dweebs?
Some things that I miss the most about college, I think, would have to be just interaction, just simple interaction. For me, I depend a lot on talking to people and being very intimate, very active. And even I worked at Chabot College, and a lot of my job that I enjoyed so much was speaking to students, connecting with students, and it was such a passion of mine. And to just lose that and that privilege have been taken away from me, it was really, really hard. And some things that I missed about the dweebs was that we'd always have random hangouts. You know, we would randomly hang out, like get boba or go to a view or something. And those would always be the best times. Like, it would be such a good time and such an unplanned thing. And they would always end up being so successful and brought us closer when we drifted a little bit. So because of COVID, that being taken away, just that privilege alone to even just hang out something small, it was hard.
So by the time COVID happened, I was going to the University of Riverside, UCR, and it was a great decision because since I was an upperclassman, I took all film classes, and I luckily found a group of friends that have all the same interests as me. finally found what I was looking for, and I was looking for that in the University of Oregon. Didn't work out, but I did find them in Riverside. It was awesome going to classes all together, and then after that, going to one of our houses and watching a movie together for homework and doing homework together, making films together, projects together, and just being adults and doing all that college scene together, and having all that taken away from you because of COVID. More importantly, having your last year of college taken away from you because of COVID. I had a lot of fun in Riverside, but it was definitely cut short because of COVID, so that sucked. What I missed the most about the dweebs? Just them. I luckily, for some of the guy friends like Matthew in our salon and Kevin, we did play video games almost every day. Call of Duty and Apex and all of that. But, you know, it's not the same as being in person, so.
But again, like, we all craved each other, but we definitely, you know, got on Zooms. We played a lot more video games.
Friendly precision airstrike inbound.
Got him.
Helicopter.
Ooh.
Got me all around.
Got him. Ooh.
Well, number one thing I miss is just being there. You know, the online school back home, I had a house that I was renting with my friends. That was going to be senior year. We were all 21. Like, that was going to be the best year. That was like the year we were all waiting for. And then it was so anticlimactic, and we all go home and we're just on the computer all day long. You miss your friends, you miss your teachers. Just walking to class and sitting down with your backpack and a pencil, like, that just killed me over time, you know, because you begin to wonder, like, why am I even doing this? You don't retain any knowledge that you learn in class, and most of it is just a blur. So COVID was, you know, I'm grateful that I was in college for the years that I was there, but, you know, COVID was, it was a struggle.
COVID was a funny time for me because I enjoyed my time in quarantine. A lot of people did not, but for me, I mean, there was off times. There was time basically where, like, COVID had stopped me from meeting people or, like, you know, strengthening a relationship. It really stopped that. But after I got past that part, and, you know, unfortunately not being able to hang out with you guys, that sucked actually, because, like, that was like. Like, yeah, I still have, like, my close friends that sometimes will go out or, like, will try to. But with you guys, you were across, you know, and, like, a lot of people were doing their own thing. It was hard to get with you guys. But, you know, I think after that, it was a good payoff. But I was the most productive year of my life, so.
I used to drink milk and eat hotcakes, but that's a metaphor for the game, and this is a hot take. I'm too sharp, y'all just get skipped like Bayless. While you playing this, I'm heinous, ahead of the game. Y'all adjacent to the anus, I get my kicks out the pain, and y'all just kicking shit like Payless. Real ones don't talk, so I say less. Kim's kitty, you got them loose lips. I'm cursed like reverse words, so doom is what the mood is. Mouth gone.
I was able to just like zone out, and I canceled. Like, people were trying to, like, it was like a little more towards the end, but still, like, people were like, oh, let's go to this party, let's do this thing, let's do this little hangout, right? I was like, no, I would tell them that I was scared of COVID, whatever, that's like this and that. I was just sitting there at home writing music, you know, like, I got really productive. And it's something that I learned, like, what I learned about myself is, if I'm put in a position where I'm forced to stay home, where I'm forced to think, where I'm forced to write,
I could do it. You know, where I push myself, where it's like, I'm going to, and I have fun with it. It's like, I'm going to go home and write this music, you know, and I wouldn't have realized that without quarantine, without being forced into a position where it's like, you have to be creative or you're just going to fall.
What were some things you realized about yourself during quarantine?
Oh, I started to realize how weak-minded I was a lot. I started to realize and pinpoint my weaknesses. And it just took that time with solitude, a lot of solitude, a lot of being by yourself and thinking. It was a dangerous place to be, but also a very beautiful place because you started to realize who you are, what are your toxic traits, what can you improve, what are you lacking in certain aspects of your life. And that helped me realize a lot about myself and what I could do better and to better myself as a human being.
I think I realized that you know, noticing like a lot of people like passing away. I've had my own family members that passed away, and I think that spending more time with the people that you love, that's what I realized I had to do more, even with like family and stuff. It's hard, 'cause I think I realized that I had a lot of regrets, you know, even before COVID, like the tragedies that have happened in my life. I've had a lot of regrets, and I still haven't learned from them. And with COVID, you know, losing a lot more people, it's like you have a lot more regret and that guilty feeling. So I think I definitely want to try to improve with that, you know, spend more time with my family. That's definitely something that I wanted to do. Yeah, noticed within me. That's
great. You know, I want to have like a very profound wisdom to share with you, but it's honestly self-control, discipline, and structure was the only thing that was keeping me going. You know, I had a couple close friends, like you were my really good friend, and I had a relationship at the time that, you know, having a person to talk to and your own self-control was like, that was the bread and butter. Or else you're going to sink. You're going to sink into a really dark depression, and it's going to be hard to pull yourself out of that. So I think I would like to think that I have better discipline now when it comes to study habits and like my work ethic. I like to think that I can produce better results, probably better work than I ever did when I was in college, because I didn't have any distractions. So that was one thing that was the silver lining.
That's good. I realized a lot during quarantine. There were a lot of nights where I just had a lot of eureka moments, or I felt like a kid forever, because I was treated like a kid by almost everybody I knew or I know. So COVID, or the quarantine being around like 15 to 16 months, it was during the time where, you know, I didn't really celebrate a 21st birthday. I turned 22. And those, being 21 and 22 in college is like the year of pivotal steps into transitioning from a kid to an adult. I didn't really have that because I was just stuck at home all day. So I was really sad coming to the realization that like, I was 20 and now I'm 22. And I am basically, you know, hitting the ground running about just adulthood and being afraid about the future of being my own person and taking care of myself.
Hello?
What's up, bro? So, how is everyone?
I wouldn't know, though.
Why? What happened? Policeman, swear to God, love sleeping from the guns. I know my friends and I would probably...
As the group is getting older, were there some difficulties regarding trying to keep you guys together? Have any of you fought during this time?
I don't know if anyone was fought. I don't know if that was ever a thing that really went down. Maybe like disagreements here and there, but nothing like super crazy.
I think some of you guys have definitely fought, not me, because I don't care.
I fought with Vanessa over stupid stuff over text. I get in fights with the guys over their relationships with girls. You know, that just happens because we're young, but in the end, we all know how much we care for each other. We're the type, our friends are funny because we're not fake to each other. We're honest. If there's something we don't like, we call it out, because if it's not healthy for you, we call it out. We're not fake about it. We're not fake about seeing each other. And at first I used to freak out a lot because I lived far away. I lived 8 hours away, and I was worried that if we didn't text every day, we'd lose connection with that. You know, that's not really the case, because they're all like my really close friends, and they're the type of friends where you don't need to see them every day to reassure the friendship or like to be able to sustain it. There were times where I used to get frustrated that they wouldn't reply back to me when I asked to hang out or, you know, go on FaceTime and all of that. But I've come to the realization that, like, you know, everyone has to do their own thing, and we've all had gaps of maybe like a few weeks of not talking to each other, but we always come back at the end.
It was hard on everybody, but definitely the past year has been difficult. I think everybody started to change a lot. They started to, you know, we developed this almost like sense where we were all by ourselves, and we didn't even want to reconnect, you know. Even for me too, I personally was going through a lot. I really wanted to be alone, and I was starting to enjoy my alone time, so wanting to hang out with people was very strange. And I feel like that was a lot of us too. A lot of us were not allowed to go out. We were not allowed to experience and go outside and stuff like that. So I think we definitely hit a few brick walls, and, you know, someone had always managed to bring us back, or, you know, bring back the conversation, or, you know, address what was going on, and we can all put in our two cents on it. And it always came back regardless of the brick walls.
You know, kind of, there was just a few bumps in the road, but I think we all care about each other. I think that's what matters. So that just kind of showed through all that.
You know, so we all have different schedules. You know, Noah, you lived in Sacramento. Other people were in Union City. We have another friend who lives in San Diego. So life just happens. And every now and then we're able to hang out, and that's nice. But it's not going to be as often as we might like. But that's part of growing up.
Now in your early 20s, what are some tips you would give your 17-year-old self?
To my 17-year-old self? Oh, wow, I love her.
Don't care about what other people think.
It doesn't matter what people think.
Forget all these people, man.
Just think it out. Just, like, make sure you're prepared.
You know, enjoy the time that you're there. Make the most out of every single opportunity. If the school is going to have, like, a gym or clubs or any kind of opportunity to meet new people, definitely do it, because you don't know who you're going to meet, and those people could end up being like your best friends. And it's like you meet people in the most unlikely places, and I think that is the most important thing, is that's what makes it an adventure. I think where a lot of people don't want to get out of their comfort zone, they don't want to like put themselves out there because it's a little scary, and it is. But that's part of like what makes it the journey, right?
Don't be afraid, be yourself, and experience life for what it is, because it's too short.
Not from a pessimistic point, but more like a realistic point, where it's like a lot of people aren't gonna be here for you. You know, like to my 17-year-old self, I would be like, find your confidence, be yourself, you know, stand up for yourself. You know, don't let people push you to the side. Don't let people decide who you are. Just do you.
Focus on the people you love the most, spend time with them, because that you can't get back lost time. I think try different things until you see what you love, because when I took up photography, I didn't know how to do photography. I didn't know that I was good at it. I look at other people and I'm like, that they're so great, like I wish I could be like them. But when I tried to do it, like it just clicked with me, you know, like I got better and better and better. So yeah, definitely try, don't give up, don't be scared.
Now in your early 20s, do you think your group will stay close in the future?
Yes, because if we could do it through college life of meeting different people, going to different college parties without each other, but still coming back to each other and it being successful, I think that we could go through anything now.
I definitely think so. I think especially after us recently traveling together, I feel like that was a big sign that we can do anything. We can really do anything as long as we continue to have that love for each other and respect each other and the want to continue to grow together. I think as long as we always have that, we'll always stick it through.
You know, when we start to like actually like do our own things and like settle down, whatever, right? Whatever that means, settle down. But like, you know, I think that's gonna be tough when we reach a point where we're in our late 20s. It's gonna be, you know, we're not gonna be partying like we were when we were young. We're not gonna be doing all these things. But I think we'll find a way to stay close, you know, calling phone, FaceTime is a thing, so it's...
I think so. You know, if we all got through college and now we're back, you know, now I'm back living in the Bay Area, I think, you know, this is gonna be a solid group for a long time.
I definitely think so. Looking at the pattern, you know, we've done this interview before, when we all graduated high school, and I think a few people were like, you know, yeah, we're gonna be distant. I don't know. We may have new groups of friends and stuff, but it looks like we're all back together, square one. You know, I think yeah, definitely we'll. I envision us, you know, at a good Thanksgiving dinner with all our own families together, you know, a nice big dinner. So yeah, I definitely expect us to be together.
What are some goals you would like to have as a group as you're all growing up?
I definitely think we should travel more.
We're in our 20s, Vegas.
I'd love to take you guys to India one time.
You know, go to Japan or something, I don't know.
Well, I definitely want to see everybody succeed in whatever path that they go forward with. And, you know, we all support each other. So, you know, when everyone has their big moment of whatever their career is, you know, just having friends along the way, supporting that and being part of that, witnessing that, I think that's gonna be like the highlight to say like, hey, we finally made it. Like we came from high school and now we're here. You know, that's gonna be like the biggest payoff.
I would say in order to keep contact, I love to have this rule of, even though we won't hang out every weekend or every month, as we're getting older into our late 20s, into our 30s, I would still love to have a plan of like, we'll always be there for each other's weddings, for each other's birthdays, for our kids' birthdays, just all the big milestone moments. Even though we won't be there for the little things and everyday things, I really hope that we could still stick together through those big milestone moments of life.
What has been your favorite get together?
Well, the Santa Cruz trip.
We went to Santa Cruz as a group.
I think it was our Santa Cruz trip.
I think the last one. I think the last one, Santa Cruz, I think it was so great because it had a little bit of everything. Like, we had moments where we were having fun and partying together, but also relaxing and chilling at the beach, but also like very intimate moments and deep talks and conversations. And I think that's all you really need sometimes, like those type of moments together.
Such a great thing when you can come together after not being there for a long time and be able to tell each other the same jokes and like, you know, like vibe like that. So it was great.
Who's most likely to become the first successful?
Noah.
Vanessa
or RC?
Who's most likely to become a celebrity?
Probably Noah.
Noah.
Kevin.
Who's most likely to get married first?
Noah.
Probably Noah.
Moment.
Vanessa.
Who's most likely to have a kid first?
It's a guy named Noah.
I think Noah.
No and Jada.
Josh.
Vanessa?
If you were in a tough time, who would you call?
Matthew.
Noah.
DJ.
Noah or Matthew?
Noah.
If you were stranded, who would you want with you?
Josh.
DJ.
Rigo?
If you wanted to have a good night to party, who would you bring along?
Vicky.
DJ.
Josh.
Well, Vanessa and probably Rigo.
I just want to say that I appreciate this entire group, every single one of you guys. You guys have made my childhood from high school to now my adulthood super fun, and I just want to continue making memories and just keep giving the fun vibes, and I see us being friends for a really, really, really long time. And I wish the success and fame and love and prosperity to every single one of you. So much love to you all.
We may not talk all the time, hang out all the time, but I realize now you guys do have my back, you guys do support me, and I support each and every one of you guys. And each of us is special. Each of us have a special thing that we're doing, and just keep doing that. You know, because I love each and every single one of you guys. I want each and every single one of you guys to stay successful, keep doing what we're doing, and stay blessed. And we will. And I think we'll get through all the bullshit in life. I think we'll do this. And we'll find a way, and we'll stay close no matter what.
Man, it's been an amazing ride. This ride is still going. So, you know, I can't wait till we get to the destination. I love you guys. You guys have been such good friends with me. You guys have been through my tough times. So I won't give up on you guys ever. And much love from RC.
I love all of you guys. And hopefully we continue to thrive. And every year gets better than the last. You know, we made it through COVID. And like, let's just keep it going, keep it strong, and I'll always have your guys' back.
I don't know. I want to keep it short and simple because, I mean, you know how much I care about you guys and everything we've been through, because we've all been through a lot individually and together. Just, you know, you guys mean the world to me. And honestly, after the, you know, going through hard times during college, I honestly don't think I would be in the position I am now without you guys. I feel happy, you know, even though I'm not where I am career-wise, I do feel successful, partly because of your guys' support and you guys always being there for me, and I love being there for you. And, you know, we've been together since the beginning, and we'll be there together for the end. And you know, I can't wait to see you guys thrive, because all you guys are hardworking and you deserve everything. I just can't wait to make more memories with you guys, and we'll all probably see it because I'll be recording. But yeah, thank you. Okay. Yeah. Teenage wasteland.